Right, I believe on the line we have Phillip Taaibosch of SANTACO, the taxi organization from Pretoria. Mr. Taaibosch, your response to this ongoing case, it just sounds like our reporter was saying earlier, like something out of a movie.
thank you for having us on your program, and good evening to your viewers. Yes, this matter which happened over yesterday in KwaZulu-Natal has actually devastated the industry. We are totally taken by surprise because we never thought that such a thing could happen anymore in the industry, as we saw a big number of decline in violence in the country. But well, it happened, and I visited the IPTA offices, the association in Tembisa, and I was told that the association itself, neither the association operators, neither the drivers, had a conflict with any other route or any other grouping. So they were also surprised to have heard about the shooting that took place. But nevertheless, we wanted to pass our condolences to the families of the bereaved members, and also to those who were injured in the accident, and indicate that as a taxi industry, we really don't take lie to what has happened, because this continues to undermine and to put in our industry in a bad light in society. We are not a violent industry. We may have our violent past, but we have improved from that, and we have accepted what the new government brought into the store. So those who are still involving themselves in violent acts, I think we must leave it to the law, for the law to take its course. And also must indicate that we were pleased for the first time in the South African police services that our national police commissioner, Kehla Sithole, has indicated that in the next 72 hours, he is looking for results, and he is looking for people to be arrested. And I just want to add that as the president of the taxi industry in SANTACO itself, we are saying that if these people who have killed these drivers happens to be taxi operators, an operator is the person owning the taxi. If it happens to be a taxi operators, we would definitely, after their arrest and after their prosecution, request the Minister of Transport to ensure that their taxi license are being taken. Because, you know, because of lack of prosecution in the conflicts which has taken place in the industry, there are so many people who believe that they have a right to do whatever they want to do. And we believe the time has arrived for the law to be stringent and to ensure that these operators lose their operating licenses. If it's an operator with 1 or 5 or 10 or 20 taxis, if he's found guilty by the court of law, we believe that the minister must revoke the Section 91 and ensure that the operating licenses belonging to that particular operator are being withdrawn.
All right, unfortunately, we cannot take it up now. You're basically saying you're completely in the dark. I think anyone who's seen the ongoing taxi violence would be hard-pressed to believe this isn't taxi-related, but we'll wait for those investigations. Phillip Taaibosch from SANTACO, the president there from Pretoria.